read all about it. It happened this week-ish.
Thank you very much indeed. What a week we have in front of us, and welcome back, Joe Hildebrand. I tell you what, that dicko, second rate. Anyway, just joking, Dicko, if you're watching, you'll be in tears.
Why don't you get on with it?
What was that, executive producer?
Is this your last It Happened This Week?
No, it could be my last show, though. 1997, the release of Men in Black. Do you remember Men in Black? Directed by Barry Sonnenfeld. Mm. Grossed, I think it was it, as $589 million at the box office. Danny Elfman composed all the music, the guy who was in Oingo Boingo and wrote a lot of music for Batman and also for The Simpsons.
Simpsons theme song.
And that was a great movie. Then they did the second one, which I don't think was so good.
No.
It was good, but it wasn't that great. But they make a lot of money out of the soundtracks of those movies. So Men in Black came out this week, 1997. Also, if you cast your mind back, for those kids around Australia who are now on school holidays, get yourself a book. There's a good one called Gone with the Wind that was published in this week in 1936, written by a lady by the name of Margaret Mitchell. And I think Aita Shani recently died a couple of years ago, didn't she?
I think so.
Or she may have been killed in an accident or something. Then they found this other book and they said, oh, this is almost as good as Gone with the Wind, but I don't think so. It got a Pulitzer Prize in 1937, National Book Award for 1936. And, of course, the movie came out. So if you don't want to read the book, you can go and see this amazing movie. It's now been re-released on Blu-ray. It's a long film. It used to have an intermission in it when it first came out.
Quicker to read the book
than it is maybe, to the movie. 1939 is a great film. Clark Gable and, of course, Vivian Leigh, who was a little bit crazy when they...
No, she was glorious.
Not in the movie.
No, she was glorious.
She was very beautiful.
She wasn't the first choice.
Look at Clark Gable.
And that, of course, a lot of famous lines came out, like...
Frankly, my dear, I don't give a damn.
Yeah, that's what my wife always says. Frankly, my dear, I don't give a damn.
So many famous lines. Yeah,
famous so many famous lines like, play it again, Sam. directed by Victor Fleming. Great movie. Haven't seen it? Check it out on the DVD. You can fast forward through the boring bits. Now, 1976, The Clash. London Calling. The Clash played their first gig in the UK on this week, on the 4th of July. Remember The Clash?
Yeah.
Joe
yeah.
Strummer, Mick Jones and all the guys. And their famous songs, London Calling, Rock the Snack Bar. I'm sorry, Rock the Casbah.
I love that song.
That was a Weird Al Yankovic send-up version. Should I Stay or Should I Go? So they were the opening act for the Sex Pistols. How bizarre is that? There they are. This is filmed at the first gig, which took place in London and Sheffield, in fact, at the Black Swan Pub in Sheffield this week, 4th of July. So, celebrity birthdays. If you're having a birthday, anyone in the audience having a birthday? Great. Matt Preston from MasterChef is having a birthday. He's 54. There he is there. He's the big guy next to me. Also having a birthday today.
He used to be a punk rocker, actually.
He did,
Matt Preston,
didn't he?
Back
and
in the
that's
day.
Pamela Anderson. Pamela Anderson, 48 today. That's at Claridge's Hotel in London. This is for a radio interview, and she took an hour and a half to get made up for it in a bathrobe. So I said, does she know it's just radio? She always does this for radio. Margot Robbie, the beautiful Margot Robbie, the new Mrs. Coleman, in fact. I'm currently married to another Margot, but she will be... Oh, I hope she's not watching.
This isn't going on here, is it?
25 today. Happy birthday, and Sarah, as this is my last show ever,
No, that was smooth. Smooth as silk.
As they say, Sarah, the rest is history. Round of applause. Thank you.
That was actually the best one.
What is it? What does it matter when you've got chest pains and searing abdominal cramps? Let's ask a TV doctor. Good to see you, Normie.
Yeah, I'm not. All right.